and my wife, my brother Joe, took off in my Ford from San Pedro. We hadn't much gas and the tires were low, but the doggone Ford could really go. Now along about the middle of the night, we were ripping along like plain folks might, when a Mercury behind, he blinked his lights and he honked his horn and he flew outside. We had twin pipes in the Columbia butts. You people may think that I'm in a rut, but to you folks who don't dig the jive, that's two carburetors in an overdrive. We made grease spots out of many good towns and left the cops' heads spinning round and round. They wouldn't chase, they'd run and hide, but me and that Mercury stayed side by side. Now we were Ford men and we likely knew that we would race until something blew, and we thought it over, now wouldn't you? I looked down at my lovely bride, her face was blue, I thought she died. We left streaks through town about 40 feet wide, but me and that Mercury stayed side by side. My brother was pale, he said he was sick, he said he was just a nervous wreck. But why should I worry, for what the heck, me and that Mercury was still neck and neck. Through the deserts we did glide, a-flying low and a-flying wide. Me and that Mercury was a-taking a ride, and we stayed exactly side by side. Then I looked in the mirror and I saw something coming, and I thought it was a plane by the way it was a-running, humming along at a terrible pace, and I knew right then it was the end of the race. When it flew by us, I turned the other way, and the guy in the Mercury had nothing to say, for it was a kid in a hopped-up Model A. Yeah, just a hopped-up Model A.